الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. الحمد لله. We're heading towards the blessed masjid called قبة الصخرة, which is the dome of the rock. And this is the masjid which marks the place where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam left this earth and ascended beyond the seven heavens and met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, met different prophets in the different heavens and saw different manifestations of what takes place after a person is judged and goes either into hellfire or into paradise, and where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and came back with the gift of the five daily prayers. An immense place filled with stories relating to the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as when we enter, you will see a rock from where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam ascended to the seven heavens. And so this is a place that was marked for its barakah, and it was marked in order that it would preserve a section from the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Muslims in the past, they marked the places of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam so that they wouldn't be forgotten. You know, these places, the times of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, are marked so that we can remember and we can actually go to these places and relive those moments of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. As you can see, a phenomenal building, a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The surrounding of the building has the inscription of Surah Yasin all the way around, which we know is the heart of the Quran. And as you will see when we enter, there's an immense spirituality and a serenity that you will feel when you come to this place, inshallah. When we have a look around the world, there are many countries whose visa is not accepted. You know, they don't get a visa to come here. So especially our brothers and sisters in the UK, we're very fortunate that we have an opportunity right now to come here and to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, see the place where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and ascended to meet his Lord Azza wa Jal. If we proceed inside, we'll be able to look at the masjid in more detail. Entering into the dome of the rock, blessed masjid. So as you can see, it's just a masterpiece of architecture and beauty, not only for a blessing and a beauty for the eyes, but a beauty for the soul as well. You know, the building, it reflects the spirituality of the events that have taken place here, and you actually feel a serenity in here that you don't really feel anywhere else. This is where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam ascended to beyond the seven heavens. And we're going to see there's a significant place here. There's an area in the masjid that contains the footprint of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and also the hairs of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
Okay.
It's not always open. It is it's closed at the moment, but you can see that the relics are maintained in here. People place their hand inside to take blessings from the tabarruk of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which was a habit of the Sahaba. The Sahaba al-Kiram, they used to take blessings from the relics of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We know Sayyidina Umar radiallahu an used to wipe his hand over the minbar of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and we know that the Sahaba al-Kiram used to take water that in which the hair of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was placed, and they used to drink it for shifa. So we have some great relics here. As we proceed further, this is the entrance into the lower part of the cave. So if we just have a look from the top, this is the actual rock that is here, and this is why it's called the Dome of the Rock. It's the dome that covers the rock from where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam ascended to the seven heavens. And underneath this rock, there is a cave where people, for the sake of blessings, they pray and they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have a look at the dome, it's over 900 years old, this structure is. It's an amazing feat of art and architecture, a true beauty. And the reason why the Muslims in the past did this, and what's mentioned, is that the
builders and the architects were in a state of dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam whilst they were doing this. And it's to do justice to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it should be the most beautiful place, a place where people feel serenity, and a place that is different to anywhere else. And so they've really done justice to that, alhamdulillah. We'll proceed into the cave.
Okay.
As you can see, it's quite busy. People have come in to pray, inshallah, take blessings from this amazing place. Where the Prophet ascended to the seven heavens. Immense place of barakah and blessings. And people will come in here, they'll pray two raka'ahs nafil, they will pray salawat on the Prophet, they will recite Quran. Just to be in a place which was connected to the Prophet. This is the aim of a believer, is that in all of their states, in terms of time, in terms of place, in terms of state, in terms of thought, a person wants to be as close to the Prophet as possible. And so we pray like him, and we try and behave like him, and we have manners like him, and we read the adhkar and the litanies like him in order to gain the closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So likewise, we want to be in those places where he was in order to attain that closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.